the bed of affliction.
Yes. Yes.
Will you line up?
Thank you.
How many of y'all want to possess it?
That's the Lord.
How many of y'all want to get the things that God really has for you? Not the things you think God has for you, but the things he really has for you. Locked up waiting for you when you get to the next level. And I love 13. It said, and it shall come to pass. Not maybe, if, and, or later. It shall. It shall come to pass. That means I ain't got to doubt it. I ain't got to walk around the house panting around like, is God going to give me a blessing? Or should I go out there and do it myself? No, all I got to do is sit still. It shall come to pass. See, if some of us in the middle of our situation say, it shall come to pass, I bet God will break out and we give him a praise. He said, it shall come to pass. So we begin to praise God, because the word says God inhabits all praise. And we begin to praise God, God will come in and begin to manifest that thing, because we said, it shall come to pass. See, we have to wait because we don't ask God for it. God said, ask and you shall receive. So if you're going to wait on asking, wow. Shall come to pass. I'm excited off that because I just asked him for some things right then and there when I read that. It shall come to pass. That's why I keep saying a lot. It shall come to pass. God Almighty. And then he said that just as you were cursed among nations. See, some of y'all have been outcast in your family. Some of y'all have been outcast among the in crowd, the people in your neighborhood. Nobody never understands you. So look, God was saying, he said, look, I told you the good part first. Now, some people don't like the bad, what you have to go through. So that's why he said, this is what glory is. But this is what you got to go through to get to. So he said, just as you were cursed among nations, just because you were talked about, Jesus was talked about. Just as you were, set off by the wayside, people that you thought would be with you, your friends. Jesus' friends turned his back on him. Matter of fact, turned him in to get hung up on the cross. So why are you mad? You ain't have to get hang on no stick of wood, stacked up like this, stretched out nails in your hand. I got it. Yeah. I had surgery on my foot and the thing hurt. So I can only imagine what Jesus had to go through hanging on a cross and then looking at people ridiculing me. Yeah. Right. Crown of thorns. So imagine something like that sticking in your brain. See, we got it easy. We got it easy.
Yeah, we do, bro.
So just as you were cursed among nations, O house of Judah and O house of Israel. I like how he broke this down to me. He says, O house of praise. Our house is a praise. Our temple is a house of praise. We should praise God because he inhabits us. He comes on the inside and starts working on us. He said that no house of Israel, see, I like Israel, even though they were hard-headed, even though they knew what God can do, they still asked God, they still wanted to see God do more. So I like how they were thirsty, but they had some flaws. And all of us sin and come short of the glory of God. So, oh, house of Israel, me, see, me. I know you're God. I've seen your miracles. I've seen you do works and wonders. But I still don't believe sometimes. I still get weary. I still fall short of your glory. But I know I'm chosen and set apart for a time such as this. So Lord God, I just want to praise you so you can come in and take care of that doubt. See, because that was the biggest thing in the church that draw people astray. Stubbornness is probably second. But doubt. Because if the enemy can get you doubting, what God can do.
Yeah.
he starts tampering with your faith.
Yes.
And we know this walk with God is all about faith. So, O house of Israel, so you were cursed, but your house is still a house of praise. Your temple is still a house of praise. You have some flaws like Israel, but you're still a house that was chosen by God. God says, so I will save you. We want to be saved by everybody else but God. We want to be saved by the lottery. We want to be saved by Carl. Some of us want to be saved by Mandy. But God said, I will save you. So us looking at all these other people to come in and rescue us, our perception of these fleshly eyes is messing us up. See, we got to see in the spirit. See, because with these fleshly eyes, if we're looking at anything other than the favor of Jesus Christ, where God wants us to go, we're looking. He said, look to the hills when cometh our help. So if we ain't looking to the hills.
Praise the Lord. Yeah.
I'm going to keep it moving. I'm going to keep moving. Stay caught up quick. I'm trying to tell you when I think about the goodness of God. So he said, I will save you, and you shall be blessed. You shall be blessed.
Yeah.
That's why I said, speak that thing. You got to declare that your seed is prosperous. Uh-huh. You shall be blessed. When God cleaned you up, how many, are we going to take you a walk down memory lane? I'm actually do the walk. He's giving it to me just as I'm doing it. This is hot off the press. God just text messaged me this. So bear with me. I hope y'all receive it. When we were here, a wretch, deep in sin, I don't know what you're saying, but you know what. I ain't pulling nobody's, stepping on nobody's feet, pulling nobody's coattail. Now, when you were here, you were still blessed. You just didn't know it yet. God said he saved you. And as you begin to press it your way, he began to change you, mold you. That you can walk in the fullness thereof in the blessing. So you went through all that. How many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 rows. This might be 8 years worth of stuff, 18, whatever. Because I don't know your story, but God knows it. Because your mother, your grandmother, somebody prayed for you. Somebody planted a seed, was laying crying on their bed for your seed to be prosperous. You are here, standing, because God saved you. And now you shall be blessed.
Thank
you. You shall be blessed.
Yes.
And then the next part says, don't fear. Don't be scared.
God
didn't raise no punks. My God's not a wimp. He has all power and the authority. So what you scared of? What that little light affliction, that little situation that you're looking at, why is it holding you from going forth in God like never before? Why is it causing you not to plant your seed when God's telling you to plant your seed now so that your harvest can be right in the time that your season is to produce it to get fruit? Don't fear. God didn't give us the spirit of fear. We're supposed to fear him. But he didn't give us the spirit of fear for this world, this earthly world. And then he said, let your hand be strong.
Yes.
See, I realized back in Exodus when Moses was talking to God himself, God said, what's in your hand?
Yes.
Moses said it was a rod, a little inanimate object, but God saw it was more power in that rod than he could even understand. So God said, it's in your hand. Whatever you want to do, it's in your hand. You have to reach out, grab it. And when your seed is in your hand and you begin to plant it, and you know that your hand produces power, everything you touch, everything that you come in contact with shall be blessed.